soldier came knocking upon the queen's door, and he said, I'm not fighting for you anymore. And the queen knew she had seen his face someplace before, and slowly she let him inside. He said, I watched your palace up here on the hill, and I wondered who's the woman for whom we all kill. But I'm leaving tomorrow, and you can do what you will, but only I'm asking why. Down the long narrow hall he was led in, tapestries red. She never once took the crown from her head. She asked him there to sit down, and he said, I see you now, you're so very young. I've seen more battles lost than I've seen battles won. Got this intuition, it's all for your fun. Now tell me why, oh why. Well, the young queen, she fixed him with an arrogant eye. She said, you won't understand, and you might as well not try. But her face was like a child, and he thought she would cry. She said, I swallowed the scarlet burning thread. It cuts me inside and often I bled. And he laid his hand then on the top of her head and bowed her down to the ground. Tell me now, are you hungry? How weak you must feel, cause you're living alone and you'll never reveal. But I won't march again on your battlefield. And he took her to the window to see. Now the sun, it was gold, and the sky, it was grey. She wanted more than she could ever say. But she knew how it frightened her, and she turned away and could not look at his face again. He said, I want to live as an honest man. I get what I deserve and give what I can. And to love a young woman, I don't understand. Your highness, your ways are very strange. But the crown, it had fallen, she thought it would break, and she stood there ashamed of the way her heart ached. And she took him to the doorstep and she asked him to wait. She would only be a moment inside. Out in the distance, her order was heard, and the soldier was killed while waiting for the word. Then the queen was strangling on in the solitude she preferred.